Hello everyone and welcome back. Our next guest is Sandra Dillon, and Sandra is a patient of Dr. Katrina Jameson at UC San Diego. So Sandra, tell us your story.
Hi. I started to see Dr. Jameson back in, 2010, 2011. I have a rare form of blood cancer. It's called myelofibrosis. And when I started to see Dr. Jameson, I was actually getting pretty, really sick with that, from that disease. And at the time, there weren't a lot of treatment options, but I was referred to Dr. Jameson because she was running a trial for a new treatment, and she was able to get me on that trial.
How did you feel about that? I mean, experimental therapies are promising in many ways, but they're experiments. I mean, how much did she explain to you about the amount of the dose you would get? Because sometimes in early stage clinical trials, you're not getting what's considered the optimum dose. You're given a safe dose just to make sure it doesn't do any more harm.
Yes, it was, at the time, I was actually quite afraid of seeing doctors, of going to medical institutions. My experience had just been really rough, but I was really getting sick, and I knew that I needed to overcome that fear of going to hospitals and being treated. That said, also combine it with an experimental treatment. But when you're really in a position where you need something that doesn't exist yet, I felt also that this was an opportunity to really, have hope, right? Get a chance to be on something that could work where nothing was available.
Did the fact that it was being done at an academic medical center, a big place like UC San Diego, did that help reassure you in any way?
Oh, most definitely. The combination of going to the Morse Cancer Center, which they are amazing to their patients. I just always had the warmest reception from absolutely everyone I interacted with, combined with, one of the top medical institutions around. So if there was a chance for a treatment like this, then it's, it was there.
What happened afterwards? How quickly did you start to feel better?
It was pretty amazing. I had really low expectations, from how sick I was and that it was experimental, and cancer. You just expect to really, you expect it to be awful. And my experience was the exact opposite of all of my expectations. I started to feel incredible within a few months, the pain and the side effects from my actual cancer started to come down, while the side effects from the drug just weren't very prevalent. I had a little bit of upset stomach and some nausea, but compared to what I was experiencing from the cancer, it was a walk in the park.
Did you know much about stem cell research before all of this?
I really didn't. This sort of thing is not my background. And when I first got diagnosed, I went on, I tried to find out as much as I possibly could about the disease, but it's so rare, there just wasn't a lot out there. And I remember reading about some sort of gene discovery called the JAK2 that was connected with my disease, but at the time, it just seemed so far-fetched to get from, some discovery of a genetic mutation to, something I could actually use or be treated with. But shockingly, it became a treatment option so quickly, within a matter of years, which, again, that's just unbelievable and amazing.
How do you feel about being a pioneer in something? I mean, do you feel a responsibility now to talk about this all the time?
It's funny. I don't think of myself as a pioneer. You know, there's an army of researchers and doctors and people that have come together to make this drug possible. They are the pioneers. I feel both blessed to have the chance to be connected with these folks. And, you know, if anything, if, you know, my participation in this trial has it's helped me, but the opportunity that it could help other people is truly meaningful to me.
Well, I mean, all that great work that the researchers do, if it doesn't help people like you, it's up for nothing. So yes, you are very much a pioneer. Sandra, thank you so much for joining us. It's been a pleasure talking to you.
Thank you.